Pierre-Marc Johnson, how does the current crisis impact international trade today?
The main impact, of course, is restriction on people's movement and the fact that it takes people usually to conclude the contracts, and it takes people, of course, to bring goods across borders. And the confinement and the necessity to contain the effects of COVID-19 have brought governments to be bureaucratically involved in restricting the movement of people. And that affects commerce. The WTO tells us that the impacts of trade mid-April, in the analysis and the projection they made, would be affected anywhere between 13 and 35%, which is huge. And of course, that margin is quite wide because we're not used really to these types of problems when it comes to trade.
Should we expect this sanitary crisis and the related environmental awareness to slow trade? Or, on the contrary, will the economic recovery sooner or later intensify it again?
The crisis has made us more aware of where we are. Through our senses, you can actually see the Himalayas now. When you're in northern India, there's less smog. There seems to be more birds around us than before. And our skin seems to be a little more comfortable because there's no soot and there's no smog in our cities. And that generates an extraordinary sense of the importance of environment. When it comes to environmental concerns, there's a tendency to maintain the dichotomy between more environment is less trade, or more environment is less economy, or more trade and more economy is less environment. That dichotomy is still there when it comes to governance in most societies. That said, the equation is not that simple. And hopefully, governments which are more progressive and governments which have integrated more the real concept of sustainable development and its three-prong approach, which is the economy, the environment, and social development, these governments might have the possibility to intervene in more radical ways than in the past. And in that sense, the crisis might have generated opportunities to change where the world is going when it comes to pollution and the environment. I think coming out of the crisis, the governments will address environmental issues not as much as a concept of command and control through regulation, but largely as a sector where investment becomes a source of satisfying concerns of citizens, jobs, and the new economy.
This crisis has underlined the weaknesses of our global and interconnected economy. In your opinion, Pierre-Marc Johnson, on what scale should our economies be reorganized?
In practice, for most OECD countries, there's anywhere between 15 and 60% of their GDP, which is related to international trade. So the day you stop international trade, it's going to be worse than the COVID-19. But there'll be a temptation to try to build national capacity in all these sectors. Governments will probably try to subsidize national industries related to health services and mostly goods. And that's technically against most WTO and international trade agreements. Even with the existing WTO or some of the free trade regulation, states tend to try to favor their national enterprises. And I think there'll be more pressure for that and possibly of some changes to international regulation. That said, I don't believe the WTO will be revolutionized. I don't think it will be abolished. And I think free trade agreements are going to go through some difficult moments, but they'll be maintained because the reality of growth and prosperity, which people want usually, goes through international trade.